The natural body, temporary. The spiritual body, for eternity. The body is sown in corruption. The natural body, it is raised in incorruption. The spiritual body, it is sown in dishonor. The natural body, it is raised in glory. The spiritual body, it is sown in weakness. The natural body, it is raised in power. The spiritual body, it is sown in natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body, and there is a spiritual body. The first man, Adam, became a living being, the natural body. The Lord Jesus became a life-giving spirit, the spiritual body. The spiritual body is not first, but the natural body. Afterward comes the spiritual body for all eternity. The image of the man of dust, Adam, is the natural body. The image of the heavenly man, Christ, is the spiritual body. As we believers are born in the image of the natural body, we shall one day soon bear the image of the spiritual body. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood, the natural body, it cannot inherit the kingdom of God Almighty. The being caught up together, once a mystery, the natural body will be changed for all eternity. We believers shall not all sleep before Jesus comes for his bride, which is not to be confused with Jesus coming with his bride. Pre-tribulation believers, the dead and the living will be changed by God's hand, will be instantaneously, supernaturally changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. The dead will be raised, the living changed at the blowing of that trumpet. Pre-tribulation dead believers raised in their spiritual bodies. Pre-tribulation living believers change into our spiritual bodies. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, the spiritual body, and this mortal must put on immortality, the spiritual body. First born of water, the natural body, which is temporary, then born of the Holy Spirit, the spiritual body, for all eternity. The Lord Jesus Christ will descend from heaven at the command of God, with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God. Pre-tribulation dead believers will rise in their spiritual bodies. Pre-tribulation living believers change into our spiritual bodies. All pre-tribulation believers caught up together in the air. In the clouds, far above the earth, we meet the Lord Jesus Christ there. The being caught up together, Jesus Christ coming for his bride. Jesus Christ on the white horse, Jesus Christ comes with his bride. Thus we believers will always be with the Lord Jesus Christ, in God's immediate presence with the Holy Spirit and Jesus Christ. Jesus told us we must be born again with the Holy Spirit, by faith in the gospel of Jesus Christ being the prerequisite. We stand right now in the natural body yearning to be instantaneously, supernaturally changed into our spiritual body. We are children of God, co-heirs of the kingdom of God Almighty. At the being caught up together, this comes together perfectly.